This image is showing an outline of the brain. You know that this is a Sylvian fissure. This is specifically the posterior ramus of the Sylvian fissure. This will be the anterior horizontal and the ascending rami. And this is one very important fissure that you use to identify the frontoparietal from the temporal. Now, how will you separate the frontal from the parietal? That is by the central sulcus or the Rolandic fissure. So we are going to draw the Rolandic fissure now. Just behind the midpoint between the frontal pole, this is the frontal pole and this is the occipital pole, just behind the midpoint, you draw an anteriorly curved sinuous line, and that line will typically intersect the superior medial margin. You can see the intersection of the superior medial margin, and it typically does not intersect the Sylvian fissure posterior ramus. So it just falls short of it. This is seen in 98% of people. This is the format in their brain. In 2% of people, it may go ahead and intersect. Right in front of this, you have the precentral sulcus, and just in behind this, you have the postcentral sulcus, which demarcates the two gyri, the precentral gyrus and the postcentral gyrus. Okay, this is the way how you can identify the central sulcus in a specimen. You identify these two rami that run from the superior to the inferior aspect, the two gyri, and between these two gyri you can identify the central sulcus, which will be intersecting at the superior medial margin and which will not be intersecting the Sylvian fissure. Now, what is the importance of the central sulcus? Now, central sulcus or the Rolandic fissure is separating the frontal lobe in front from the parietal lobe behind. Okay, so this is very important because just in front of this, this is the location of the primary motor area, and this is the location of the primary sensory area, which makes central sulcus one of the most important fissures in your brain, most important sulci in your brain, because just around it, in front and in back, you have the primary somatosensory area and the somatomotor area. So the sensory motor cortices are just in front and behind it.
The central sulcus you can understand by identifying two parallel gyri that are running downwards. Okay, these two are two parallel gyri that are running obliquely downwards. This, between that you have the central sulcus. This is the central sulcus. So central sulcus characteristically cuts the superomedial border. It also characteristically does not intersect the Sylvian fissure. Okay, you have a gyrus connecting, bridging between these two gyrus.
As mentioned just now, you can see the precentral gyrus and the postcentral gyrus are connected by a gyrus that is running just underneath the central sulcus, just above the Sylvian fissure. Looks like a U connecting between the precentral gyrus and postcentral gyrus. And this is known by the name the subcentral gyrus because it is below the central sulcus. Subcentral gyrus is also known as the plidy passage of Broca, also called the subcentral gyrus of Broca. I'll just take a screenshot from the previous video and I'll try to show you the precentral gyrus over here. This is the postcentral gyrus. And between that you have the central sulcus. This was defined before. Now between this you have the U-shaped subcentral gyrus that is connecting the precentral gyrus and the postcentral gyrus. Now what are the limits of these? To identify that, let me just draw the Sylvian fissure first. This is a Sylvian fissure, the posterior ramus of the Sylvian fissure. This is the anterior horizontal, anterior ascending and the anterior horizontal rami. These are the anterior rami and these are technically the posterior ascending rami that goes into the parietal lobe, and this is the posterior descending rami. These are the major rami of the Sylvian fissure. From here, you can see some minor rami. This is a minor ramus. This is called the subcentral, anterior subcentral ramus, and this is called the posterior subcentral ramus. Now, if you look carefully, you can see that the anterior and the posterior subcentral rami are limiting the U-shaped subcentral gyrus. Okay. Now, you may be wondering, what is the reason for studying all this? This is a paper that came in 2012 in American Journal of Neuroradiology, which says about the U sign, which is a 10th landmark to identifying the central region of the brain on brain surface reformatted MR imaging. Now, this projection is called the Mercator view. We know that a globe is a spherical surface, and that can be projected onto a planar surface, and this projection is known as Mercator projection. Just like that, the curved surface of the sulci and gyri of the brain can be presented on a plane surface. That is something like we can unroll the surface of this curved surface onto a plane. If that is done, a lot of features can be used to identify the central sulcus. Now, this is the central sulcus, and I want you to focus on the sign number 8 and sign number 9. Sign number 8 is this, which says that this long sulcus, which intersects the superomial margin, or if it reaches the interhemispheric fissure, that is the central sulcus. Now, if you look on the lateral side, near the Sylvian fissure, this is the Sylvian end of the central sulcus. Near there, the precentral gyrus is continuous with the postcentral gyrus, and that is this green U-shaped sign, and that is the U sign or the subcentral gyrus sign. And this 8 is the midline sulcus sign. So these two signs can be used to identify the central sulcus. This is just the radiological correlate of what we saw in the anatomy.